Tell me what kind of energy transformation takes place at a hydroelectric power plant. Yes, raise hand if you know the answer. We discussed that day. Yes, Jia.
From gravitational potential energy in water, kinetic energy of turbine, and then electrical energy of generator.
Yes, very good. So there are three energy transformations taking place. First of all, water is stored in dams at a height. It stores gravitational potential energy in it. It is allowed to fall on turbines kept at ground level with large pressure. Turbines start rotating. So that gravitational potential energy of water is converted into kinetic energy of turbines. Turbines, they run the shaft of generator and generator produces electricity. So third transformation is electrical energy produced by the generator. Okay, now who will tell me what kind of energy transformations take place at a thermal power plant? Yes. At a thermal power plant, what happens? Yes, Tanveen.
Yes, ma'am. The chemical energy of coal is converted into heat energy of water.
Yes, and then after that? It is power
plant.
So we have to go up to electrical energy. Power plant means power is produced, electricity is produced. Okay, what happens after that? Tanvi?
I don't know.
Okay, Janvi, aap batao.
And then kinetic energy of steam, then kinetic energy of turbine, then electrical energy of generator.
Yes, yes. So first of all, chemical energy of coal into kinetic energy of steam. In between, you can also say heat energy of water, then kinetic energy of steam, then kinetic energy of turbine and electrical energy by the generator. And specifically, I had shown you through that simulator that how the steam of pressure cooker is able to run the turbine and turbine is able to run the generator. So same thing is happening here also. The steam produced by boiling water, that is converted into steam. And that steam has a lot of kinetic energy that is able to run and rotate the turbines. Okay? Is that clear? So this was the energy transformation taking place. Now we are going to do the law of conservation of energy. So before we do the examples, let us state, what is the law of conservation of energy? What is the statement? Very simple, it states that total energy of any system is conserved. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be converted from one form into the other. Okay, hum na energy ko create kar sakte hain, na hum destroy kar sakte hain. We can only convert energy from one form into the other. This is called law of conservation of energy. If you take any example, for example, if you take generator also, the word generator is a misnomer here. Actually, it is not generating electrical energy. It is also converting mechanical energy into electrical energy. So we can't produce energy. We can't destroy energy as well. We can only convert one form of energy into the other. Write the statement first. The law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created. Law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be converted from. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. it can only be converted from one form into the other. It can only be converted from one form into the other. Total energy of the universe remains constant. Total energy of the universe remains constant. Okay. So now we will have the examples of conservation of energy. First example is of a simple pendulum. First example is that of a simple pendulum. What is a simple pendulum? Simply, if we attach a ball to a thread, okay, if we attach a ball to a thread, this arrangement will be called a simple pendulum. Isko hum simple pendulum bolte hain. Theek hai? But in this case, specifically, the one we are using in the lab, we are attaching a metallic pendulum bob. ठीक है, हम एक मेटालिक पेंडुलम बॉब अटैच करते हैं इसके साथ. सो व्हेन वी डिस्प्लेस इट एंड देन वी रिलीज इट, इट स्टार्ट्स ऑसिलेटिंग. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रूव दैट एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ दिस सिंपल पेंडुलम टोटल एनर्जी इज कंजर्व्ड, टोटल एनर्जी कांस्टेंट है. हम हर पॉइंट पे प्रूव करना चाहते हैं. So let us draw the oscillating simple pendulum. It oscillates like this. This position is called mean position. Central position is called mean position. And the side positions are called extreme position. This is extreme position. This is also extreme position. So at all these three positions, we want to prove that the total energy is conserved. Energy may have different forms, but sum total of the energies will remain the same at each of the following positions. Okay. So first of all, when you observe oscillating simple pendulum, when it goes towards one extreme, it stops. Only then it comes back. Rukega tabhi wapas aayega na. So when it stops here, it is not having any speed, so its kinetic energy is zero. So kinetic energy is zero at the extreme positions because the pendulum bob stops for a moment. Okay, and if we take mean position at the ground level, then at the extreme position, at it is at the highest level. And what is the formula of potential energy? MGH. So because of maximum height from the ground, you must have noticed ki simple pendulum isse high nahi ja sakta, uske baad ye low hi aata hai. So it is at maximum height at the extreme position, so that's why it has maximum potential energy at the extreme position. So because of maximum height, its potential energy is maximum here also and here also. Potential energy will be maximum. Okay, suppose it is maximum and is equal to 5 joule. So what is the total energy, mechanical energy at the extreme position? That is sum of kinetic and potential energies. That is 0 plus 5 joule. So total energy here is 5 joule. Here also, total energy is 0 plus 5, that is 5 joule. So we have seen that at these two positions, total energy is 5 joule. Now let's find out whether the total energy at mean position is also 5 joule or not. Let's find out. Okay. So you can assume when now the pendulum starts coming back to the mean position, its height goes on decreasing. Its height goes on decreasing as we go towards the mean position, and finally it comes at the ground level. So since its height has become zero, what about the potential energy at the mean position? It becomes zero. So potential energy was maximum here and zero here. So where does that potential energy go? Okay, wo potential energy gayi kahan pe? Iske paas to maximum potential energy thi. एक्सट्रीम पोजिशंस पोजिशन पे. ठीक है, नाउ लेट अस सी द अदर फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. एज इट इज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स द मीन पोजिशन स्पीड गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. So it starts possessing kinetic energy now as it moves from extreme to mean position. So that potential energy starts getting converting into kinetic energy. Aur mean position tak pahunchte kinetic energy becomes maximum, let us say 5 joule. So again total energy is kinetic plus potential 5 joule. So total energy will remain the same. Though energy was potential here, kinetic here, and potential here, but total energy, if we see at all the positions of simple pendulum, that will always remain the same. So this is in accordance with law of conservation of energy. So just after drawing this diagram in 3-4 sentences, you can explain this. Okay, just you need to explain this in 3-4 sentences. So how will you explain? You will start from the extreme position. Let us consider an oscillating simple pendulum. When the pendulum bob reaches the extreme position, it stops for a moment. So that's why its kinetic energy is zero there. And since it is at the maximum height from the ground level, it has maximum potential energy there. Okay, so all of the energy is potential here. When it starts moving towards the mean position, its height goes on decreasing. So potential energy goes on decreasing, and as speed goes on increasing, kinetic energy goes on increasing, and whole of the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy when it reaches the mean position. Who will tell me what will happen in between? Jab ye extreme aur mean ke beech mein hai, then what form of energy it is having? Yes, who will tell me? What energy will the pendulum bob possess when it is in between extreme and mean positions? Yes, Anshia.
Mechanical energy.
Mechanical energy. मतलब आप कह सकते हो half kinetic half potential होगी उस time पे, है ना? हमने कहा कि यहाँ पे maximum potential energy, here it is having maximum kinetic energy. So what will happen in between? It will have both the energies here. यहाँ पे अकेली काइनेटिक थी, यहाँ पे अकेली पोटेंशियल. सो इन बिटवीन इट विल हैव बोथ द एनर्जीज. यस, मैकेनिकल एनर्जी. ठीक है, बिकॉज बोथ काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जीज इट विल हैव इन बिटवीन. यू कैन से हाफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी हाफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इट कैन हैव. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इज दैट क्लियर? ऑल राइट, ओके. सो दिस वॉज फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल of conservation of energy. Second example is freely falling object. A freely falling object. So when an object falls freely from certain height, we want to prove at every point during the journey the total energy remains the same. ठीक है, कभी potential हो जाएगी, कभी kinetic हो जाएगी, but total energy will remain the same. Now we want to prove this for freely falling object. We'll prove this through a derivation. So write a question that can be asked. तो इसका question कैसा बनेगा? ये example तो है ही है conservation of energy का. Write the possible question also. Justify the conservation of energy. Justify the conservation of energy for a freely falling object. Justify the conservation of energy for a freely falling object. Justify the conservation of energy for a freely falling object. So let us consider an object of mass m. Suppose object ka mass hai m, and it is falling from point A, which is at a height h from the ground. Which is at a height h from the ground. So consider an object of mass m at a height h from the ground. So if it is falling freely, what will be u at point A? U will be zero. Let us find energy at point A. When the object is at point A, let us see what kind of energy it is having. First of all, let's find kinetic energy, that is half m u square, and u is zero. So kinetic energy is zero here. Is that clear? So when the object starts falling freely, it doesn't have any kinetic energy. Is that okay? Now let's calculate potential energy. For calculating potential energy, we need to have height from the point where it is dropped. So it is dropped from point A. What is the height of point A from the ground? It's h. So we write potential energy mgh. How much is total energy at point A then? Kinetic plus potential. Kinetic is zero, potential is mgh. So total energy is mgh here. We note it down and we call it equation number one. So pehle humne dekha ki ek point pe total energy is mgh. Now we will take at least two more points during the journey of this freely falling object. And if total energy there also is mgh, then our law of conservation of energy will be justified. तो हमारा ये जो लॉ है ये प्रूव हो जाएगा कि हर पॉइंट पे एनर्जी सेम रहती है. सो एट लीस्ट एट थ्री मोर पॉइंट, टू मोर पॉइंट्स वी आर टू डू, टोटल थ्री पॉइंट्स. एक पॉइंट हमने कर लिया, अब दो और लेंगे. एक लेंगे सी ग्राउंड पे एंड बी कहीं पे भी ले लेते हैं इन बिटवीन. लेट अस से बी इज एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ एक्स फ्रॉम द टॉप. सो वॉट इज इट्स हाइट फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड? इफ बी पॉइंट इज एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ एक्स फ्रॉम द टॉप, what is its height from the ground? Because for calculating potential energy, height is very important. We are to always take height from the ground when we calculate potential energy. Yes, Jia?
H minus x.
H minus x. Kyunki ye sara h hai, usme se ye x hai. So remaining is h minus x. Remaining is h माइनस x. ओके, अब जब ऑब्जेक्ट इस हाइट से ग्राउंड की तरफ फॉल करना स्टार्ट होगी, इट्स स्पीड विल गो ऑन इंक्रीजिंग, हाइट विल गो ऑन डिक्रीजिंग. सो दैट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी विल ऑल्सो गो ऑन डिक्रीजिंग हियर ऑल्सो. सो एट बी पॉइंट, व्हेन इट विल क्रॉस बी पॉइंट, इट्स वेलोसिटी विल नॉट बी जीरो, बिकॉज व्हेन इट स्टार्टेड इट्स वेलोसिटी वाज जीरो. But when it will cross B point, its velocity won't be zero. So we need to find that also. So let us assume that velocity of the object when it crosses B point is V. So we need to find that first. Because kinetic energy ke liye aapko velocity chahiye. So how we will find velocity at point V? By using third equation of motion between points A and B. Okay? So pehle hum velocity nikalte hain. That is very important. Using third equation between points A and B, using third equation between points A and B, what is the third equation? You know, V square minus U square equal to 2As. V square minus U square equal to 2As. अब u इसमें जीरो पुट कर दीजिए. लेट अस पुट इन द वैल्यूज एंड फॉर डाउनवर्ड मोशन एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी विल बी देयर. एंड व्हाट इज s? व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन a एंड b? जिन दो पॉइंट्स के बीच में आप इक्वेशन अप्लाई कर रहे हो, डिस्टेंस भी उनके बीच में ही लेना है. सो दैट इज x. फ्रॉम हियर वी फाइंड v स्क्वायर. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ v स्क्वायर इज 2gx. We don't need to write v. हमें v नहीं लिखना क्योंकि kinetic energy निकालनी है, उसके लिए v square ही चाहिए. So see, यहां तक अगर कोई point आपको clear नहीं है तो you can ask. Is that clear to everyone? Any doubt you can ask? So we can find at point B total energy. Let us find now at B point. क्योंकि अब हमें स्पीड भी पता है, हमें हाइट भी पता है, वी कैन कैलकुलेट काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑल्सो, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑल्सो वेरी इजिली. सो एट पॉइंट बी काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज हाफ एम बी स्क्वेयर. वी हैव वी स्क्वेयर विद अस, पुट दैट वैल्यू ऑफ वी स्क्वेयर हियर. यहां पे इन प्लेस ऑफ वी स्क्वेयर क्या पुट करेंगे? टू जी एक्स, हाफ एम 2gx. So the kinetic energy we have found mgx. Kinetic energy is mgx. Let's find potential energy now. B point pe, which is at a height h minus x. So it is mg h minus x. हाइट कितनी है? एच माइनस एक्स. तो वो पुट कर देंगे तो पोटेंशियल एनर्जी बन जाएगी. इज दिस स्टेप क्लियर टू यू? सी दैट हाउ आई हैव रिटन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी दिस मच. किसी को डाउट है तो पूछ लो हाउ आई हैव रिटन काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जीज हियर. ओके, सो टोटल एनर्जी इज सम ऑफ काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जीज. पुट द वैल्यूज. काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज एम जी एक्स and potential energy is mg h minus x. Open the bracket. Mg x and minus mg x get cancelled and we get total energy mg h. We call it equation number 2. So second point pe bhi aap dekho ki hamari total energy mg h hi aa rahi hai. Now at least one more point we will take, C point on the ground. अगर वहां पे भी MGH आ जाएगी, so our law of conservation of energy will be justified. So have a look कैसे हमने दो points पे पहले calculate की. Okay, fine. Chaliye, now at point C. When the object reaches point C, it falls on the ground, it has maximum speed, maximum kinetic energy. ठीक है, तो टॉप पे जो भी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी थी बॉटम पे जाते जाते काइनेटिक में कन्वर्ट हो गई. ठीक है, अब when it reaches the bottom, its speed is different, it is maximum. Let us say that speed is v dash. तो अब हमें पहले वो स्पीड भी कैलकुलेट करनी है. ठीक है, इन द सेम वे अगेन वी विल अप्लाई थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, बट नाउ वी विल अप्लाई थर्ड इक्वेशन बिटवीन पॉइंट ए एंड सी. सो यूजिंग थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन बिटवीन पॉइंट ए एंड सी, नाउ v square minus u square equal to 2as. अब v क्या है आपका? C point पे velocity क्या है? v dash. अब final velocity is v dash. u कितना है? वही zero है आपका. a is g. And now what is the distance between a and c? That is h. So you will write h now, not x. जिन दो points में आप equation apply कर रहे हो उन्हीं के बीच में distance लेना है आप. ठीक है, यू विल टेक डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दोज टू पॉइंट्स ओनली. ओके, सो वी हैव फाउंड वी डैश स्क्वायर. आई होप यू गेट दिस स्टेप. जीरो स्क्वायर इज जीरो एंड वी स्क्वायर माइनस नथिंग इज वी डैश स्क्वायर ओनली. जीरो स्क्वायर मतलब वो चला गया. आपको ये स्टेप समझ आ गया ना? इसके बाद ये जिसको नहीं आया रेज हैंड. Okay, so at point C now we are able to calculate the energy. So at C point kinetic energy is half m v dash square. वहां पे velocity v dash है ना, तो v dash square हो जाएगा. So put the value of v dash square here, 2gh. Half m और v dash square को put करेंगे 2gh. So kinetic energy at C point we have calculated is maximum now mgh. Any doubt? And since it is on the ground, this point on is on the ground, height is zero. So potential energy is also zero. So at total, at point C, total energy is kinetic plus potential, that is mgh, plus zero, that is mgh. This is equation number three. So we have seen that at all the points 1, 2, and 3, total energy will remain the same. So the law of conservation of energy is justified. क्योंकि हम देख रहे हैं कि हर पॉइंट पे, इसका मतलब at every point during the journey of a freely falling object, total energy will remain the same. Is the same. So that means the law of conservation of energy is justified. तो लिखिए, in the end you will write this comment. तो ये 1, 2, 3 इक्वेशन होगी ना, अब उसके बारे में बताना भी है आपने एंड में. तो लिखिए, फ्रॉम इक्वेशंस 1, 2, and 3, राइट दिस कमेंट इन द एंड. फ्रॉम इक्वेशंस 1, 2, and 3, वी फाइंड दैट टोटल एनर्जी at every point, we find that total energy at every point of the journey of a freely falling object, at every point during the journey of a freely falling object, remains the same. So the law of conservation of energy is verified or justified. So the law of conservation of energy is verified or justified. ठीक है, क्लियर है आपको? यस. नाउ एनी डाउट टू एनीवन यू कैन आस्क.